Hello, Doodle Lovers! Welcome to Ruby Tuesday. So this week I wanted to share with you this article that I found that I just loved and fell in love with it. I wanted to share it with you, and it is titled A Dog's Purpose. This woman was a veterinarian, and she was called to examine a 10-year-old Irish wolfhound named Belker. And the owners and their little boy, they had a 6-year-old boy. They, you know how, you know, there was a, Belker was part of their family. Like, it was just like a family member. And they were so praying that there was some miracle that could happen for this dog to survive. And after examining the dog, she found that the dog was dying of cancer. There was nothing she could do. But she offered to come to their home and perform like the euthanizing procedure. And so they made arrangements. And the couple really wanted their 6-year-old son to be a part of it. They thought he could learn from it, and they really wanted him there. I'll link this below if you want to read word for word. So the next day she came to their home, and the 6-year-old just seemed so calm, petting the dog for the last time. And she just wondered if he's really understanding what's happening. But within a few minutes, the Belker, he slipped away peacefully. And the little boy just seemed to accept that he was transitioned and that was his life, and didn't seem confused or wasn't difficult for him. And after a while, they sat together for a while after Belker's death, wondering aloud about the sad fact that animals' lives are shorter than human lives. The little boy piped up, "I know why." She said, "What came out of his mouth next stunned me. I've never heard a more comforting explanation." He said, "People are born so they can learn how to live a good life, like loving everybody all the time, being nice. Well, dogs already know how to do that, so they don't have to stay as long." She wrote, "Live simply, love generously, care deeply, and speak kindly." The author of this wrote, "Remember, if a dog was your teacher, you would learn things like, it's missing one, but the first one was, when your loved one comes home, jump up and greet them. Never pass up the opportunity to go for a joyride. Allow the experience of fresh air and wind in your face to be pure ecstasy. Take naps. Stretch before rising. Run, romp, and play daily. Thrive on attention and let people touch you. Avoid biting. Just a small growl will do. On warm days, stop to lay on your back in the grass. On hot days, drink lots of water and lie under a shady tree. When you're happy, dance around and wag your entire body. Delight in the simple joy of a long walk. Be loyal. Never pretend to be something you're not. If what you want lies buried, dig until you find it. And when somebody's having a bad day, be silent. Sit close by and nuzzle them gently." How sweet is that? I'll link this below if you wanted to read it, the whole thing. But oh, I thought that was the sweetest thing in the world. What a joy dogs can bring to the family. Like, she is our farm dog. She goes back and forth between my parents' house. They love her just as much as we love her. And she just, ugh, just who would have ever guessed that a dog could bring so much joy into your life? It's just crazy. People on the, I'm on like a Golden Doodle Facebook groups of a number of them. And people are always asking, "Am I ready for this? Am I ready for a dog? Can I do it?" And you know, it's hard. That first 8 months or so is really hard. Potty training and biting and training and crating, all those things are really hard, but it is so worth it. It's so worth it. The companionship and the love that they show and the joy they bring and entertainment. It's just, I don't know. I love it. I think it's, these dogs are the best. I can't picture myself ever living without a dog at this point now that I've had one. I just love it too much. All right, do you want to say goodbye? Thank you for watching. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. It's been so hot here. It's been over in the 90s every single day. So she's been spending a lot of time in the house just on her cooling mat, chilling. So I think I might have a few clips. So, and if not, you'll see her next week. Next week, her brother Rusty is coming to play. And I will film them playing and coming, and it's always so fun to see her and her brother play. I love it. So much fun. They haven't played together in a really long time. I can't remember the last time. And the boys are super excited because they are always at school usually when they come, so they actually get to see them play. So it'll be really fun. All right. Thank you for watching, guys. about that.